everyone. Suppose you have a table something like this, which has 428 observations and 15 variables. This is the table cars, and you have to prepare a report which should look something like this. This is summarized at type and origin, but if you notice, this has only one value for type, which is SUV. And in this cars data, you have many types, as you can see over here, SUV, sedan, and many others. So altogether, this has these many types, five types. So what will you do to create this kind of summary? What you gonna do to create this kind of summary? For that, you can simply write this type of proc SQL and you can print that. All right. So that was for one car type. What if you have to do the same thing for all of this type? So if you can say, you would say that you can simply change the car type from here. Like it was for SUV. Now, if you need to do it for sedan, you can just type sedan over here. Sedan over here, and then this would have the value for sedan. But if you look, the table name is gonna be SUV, and over here it's gonna be SUV. So for that, you'll have to change it for each and every places. So this is where we use the macro to automate this kind of stuffs. Welcome to the channel. To understand the concept very clearly, please watch the video till the end. Once you are done with watching the video, do not forget to like, comment, subscribe, and hit the bell icon. So before we proceed with automating that, let's have a look at its definition. So macro in SAS, it says macros allows us to avoid repetitive sections of code and to use them again and again when needed. It also helps create dynamic variables within the code that can take different values for different run instances of the same code. So try to read this definition multiple times, couple of times, and understand each and every word of it. What is it trying to say? And spend a lot of time. That you can do at your own pace. But now, for now, let's go ahead and try to understand this definition with this example. So here we saw that when we had to create the report for car type SUV, we just wrote this kind of value, right? Now, if you want to populate this report for sedan, I said you can just switch, you can just change the value over here. But what if you have many types, right? And you have to populate this for all of those things. For that, as I said, you can use macros. So to write a macro, what is the most important thing you need to identify? So here it says the most important thing you need to do is identify the value which needs to be changed. By now, you would have understood that this is the value which we need to change to populate this same report for different kind of car type values, right? So this is the value which we have already identified. So this is going to be the dynamic variable. So to start writing any macro, you first need to start with percent and type the word macro. This is mandatory. You have to write it everywhere, as you need to write proc SQL and quit to write any SQL statement. Same way, you need to start with macro and end this with a percent and mend. All right. But when you start a macro, you also need to provide a macro name. So type summary automation. I'm just going to provide this name to this macro. So now your macro is complete. But when you run this macro, this would not do anything. So for that, because our purpose was to automate this patch of code where we have this value dynamic, right? So to provide, because when we run this macro, we will be dynamically changing this. We would be changing this value, right? So for that, you need to provide a parameter over here. That parameter can be anything, A, or it can be B, or it can be C. But to make it more relevant, more related to the topic, I'm just going to make it type. All right, I'm just going to write a variable name type. This is going to be the dynamic variable. Now, so by now, this macro is complete. this macro is automated, this piece of code is automated. Is that correct? No. Because when you run this, this will again populate the value for SUP. So whatever value you have provided over here, whatever parameter you have given over here, the same thing. Okay, let's make it, instead of type, let's make it car type, because we already have a variable over here, type. That will not create any kind of problem, but just to avoid the confusion, I'm changing it. You can keep anything, right? So now we will just use this parameter everywhere wherever we need to change the value. Here, and the last one is here. But since this is also going to behave as hard-coded, so to make it dynamic, you need to prefix ampersand and period. So whatever parameter you provide over here, to make that dynamic, you need to prefix a ampersand and suffix a period or dot everywhere wherever you have given this. So I'm just showing you shortest method to create a macro. We will discuss each and everything in detail as we progress with this series. Now your macro is complete. So let's have a run this. Wow. But now you would say, boss, it is not showing the kind of report which we just saw. So for that, you also need to provide a value for this car type, because if we have just created this dynamic variable, so by now the macro has been fitted into the SAS memory. We have said, we have given a parameter or criteria to SAS that this kind of code you have to run. But to run this, to populate a value, you need to call this macro. To call this macro, you don't have to do anything, just put a percentage and provide this macro name. Whatever macro you want to call, you can just provide that macro name over here. So our macro name was type summary automation. And then along with that, you also need to provide the value for which you want to run this patch of code. So the value which we want to provide over here is SUV. For SUV, we want to generate this report. Now this time you don't have to run entire code. You can just run this patch of code, which is calling a macro, which is a call of macro. This will just populate the report, show the magic. Now you see the magic over here. So this is how you can automate the macro. Now if you want to populate the same report for sedan, you can just put sedan over here and you can run this. If you want to just populate this report, this kind of report for truck, you can just populate this truck. Now remember one thing, how I'm providing these all values, because this all type is already available in cars data. If you want to have a look, you can just take a procfrig data equals to sashelp.cars and tables type and run. So if you see, this already have all of this type. Okay, so this is how you can automate the work with the help of macro. Now as we progress with the videos in this series, we will understand the macros in detail, in very detail. For now, this is it. I would encourage you to apply this method, this technique to your works, and see how you can automate your task. And we will come with another video which will be detailing the elements of macros. But for now, thank you very much for watching the video. Do not forget to put your doubts in comment section. Thanks once again. Wish you